Hey mamas, welcome back to my channel. I'm Sarah, if you didn't know already. I wanted to get on really quick because I have a collab with the wonderful Jeannie from Happy Humble Home Life, and she has a really great channel. She's brand new to YouTube, but you are going to love her. So I will link her above and in the description below. We are getting on today to discuss depression and anxiety and to give you guys some tips and tricks on how to kind of cope with that in the moment if you are, you know, getting down and out. These are just some ways that you can help reduce your stress levels and keep going throughout that day, because we all know that mom life doesn't stop if you have anxiety or depression. So if you want to get some quick tips here, then keep watching. I'm going to be giving you 5 relaxation tips on ways to kind of combat the anxiety and depression. The very first thing that I like to do is some yoga. And a lot of us don't have access to like a yoga studio or anything, but there are tons of ways to do yoga right in your home, and you don't need anything fancy at all. So what I like to use, and I know it does cost money and I will link everything below, is Yoga Studio app. And what they are is an app that you download on your phone or your iPad or tablet, and you basically follow an instructor and they go through the yoga with you in the moment. So you can download beginner, intermediate, or advanced, and you will be able to kind of follow the instructor and listen to them, and they tell you how to breathe and do the poses and everything. And I find that really, really good for me, because I can't remember any of the poses to do, and just having 15 to 20 minutes with the instructor on my app helps a lot. Also, I know on YouTube you can just search for yoga at home, beginning yoga, stuff like that, and find different videos that will instruct you along the way. I know that's a free version. I happen to like this because it does document the days that I did the yoga, and there's all these different poses as well as meditations, which is another thing that you can do instead of yoga, is a meditation. So honestly, 15 minutes does a lot. If you can get away for 15 minutes, then I know that you can at least relieve the anxiety for those 15 minutes. And honestly, that's enough of a break for me. So the second thing that I would recommend is something I learned in college. It's called combat breathing. Basically what you do, so you're getting your anxiety, it's really heightened and you're in that moment, and you're just gonna stop for a minute here, and you're going to breathe in for 4 seconds, and then hold that breath for 4 seconds, breathe out for 4 seconds, hold that breath for 4 seconds, and then breathe in again for 4 seconds. You get the deal. So you're gonna go back and forth, and you're gonna do it a series of 4 rounds of holding your breath, letting it go, holding your breath, breathing in. And this is proven to reduce your heart rate, which will bring you down to a leveled anxiety level, at least for that moment. So that was another great tip that I learned about and I use. I'm just looking down because I made a list. The next thing that helps with my depression is just getting outside, and that's really hard to do when you are in a low state and you don't want to get out of bed. But if you can just get outside and go for a short walk, it doesn't even have to be brisk or anything, just get outside, get some vitamin D, you will feel so much better. At least you'll have a boost enough to come back inside and get some things done that you needed to get done. So I highly recommend that. Sometimes I bring the kids, or sometimes I just need to get outside and just be in the sun. So that was a great tip. The next thing that I like to do is using essential oils, and I love to diffuse them or apply on my skin. My favorites right now for anxiety and depression are the lavender and stress away. And these are great. I like to just put them on my wrist, go like this, smell them, put them behind my ear, and it just kind of gives me that extra boost throughout the day. Also, if I'm diffusing, it kind of keeps me motivated to get out of bed and just feel more relaxed. And then the 5th tip that I highly recommend is writing everything down. For me, when I get overwhelmed with things, I just need to make a list of everything that's going on and make my list have lists and whatever it takes. But if I just write it down on a piece of paper, I know that at least it's there and my thoughts are collected, and then I can continue adding to it throughout the day or the week. and it makes my anxiety just a little bit less up there because I am not keeping it all in my head and overanalyzing. And sometimes once I get it all out on paper, it's actually not as overwhelming as I once thought. So that's another great tip. So I hope you enjoyed these quick 5 tips. There are tons of other things, and maybe I'll go into that in the next video, but please stop by Jeannie's channel. She has a great channel, and she also has great tips on this as well. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.